Connecting a laptop can be very useful when maintaining a fire alarm system. Whether you need to review the history log from last week or even a month ago, you're running some system diagnostics, or you simply want to monitor the system while you're servicing it. So today we'll go over how to connect your laptop to a Gamewell-FCI E3 and an S3 panel, and how to properly set up the port settings on your laptop computer.
Let's have a quick peek at the inside of the E3 panel. You need to identify the main card, the ILI-MB, up on top, and the serial port is located on the lower right. This is the cable we use. It's got a 9-pin female on one side, a terminal board on the other, and you just plug in one end to the panel, the other end to your serial port. This graphic highlights where the RS-232 port is and what the terminal designations are. And this shows how to correlate the connections between the DB9 and terminal board 6.
This is where the serial port is located on the Gamewell-FCI S3 panel. It happens to be underneath the network card that's on top of the main motherboard. Here is a better view of the interior of the S3 panel with the network card moved out of the way.
Before you can communicate with the panel with your laptop, you need to set up your COM port settings. You can go to Control Panel, then Device Manager, or you can simply just type in Device Manager down below in the search bar, and it'll open it up directly that way. One thing you'll have to look at is your COM ports. This computer has a hard COM port built into it. It's an older computer. Most computers now don't have that anymore, so you have to plug in a converter or a USB serial port, and you'll want to note what COM number gets assigned to that device. We use Kitty a lot, or Putty, it's the same thing. You can use HyperTerminal, but setting up your connection, set the correct COM port. For Gamewell-FCI, the speed is 115.200. You can save that, so that way it's available to you again in the future without having to go through the settings. So we'll save that. Your enter key, you want to make sure it's just carriage return, not carriage return line feed. May affect a few things. And then the serial settings are over here if you needed to change them, but we don't need to. 8-1 and X on, X off will work. And then you can open up and connect to the panel. Now we're in our lab. We're going to actually connect the laptop to a fire panel, a Gamewell-FCI. One thing I wanted to show you is sometimes the font size on these terminal emulators is kind of small, hard to read. So you can adjust it there in the appearance settings. Once you've done that, open up your terminal connected to the panel, and you should be able to see events now as they happen. Where a device goes into trouble, now you can see it displayed, and you can acknowledge it. And if you get more trouble, you can acknowledge those. Once you fix the problems, you'll see that they restored. You can access the panel menu and print the history log, which I'll show right here. So you can see what happened previously, maybe over the weekend. You can add some space by hitting enter, and if an alarm occurs and you're connected with your phone remotely, you can silence the alarm, acknowledge the alarm, and reset the alarm.
We hope that you found this video to be helpful and informative. Please like and subscribe for more content.